My name's Scott Mowat. I'm a principal teacher in a Glasgow primary school, and I've been a member of the EIS since 2010, and each year I've been doing more and more activism within the union. I started working with the union about 2011, where I became interested in an LGBT network that was going on. It started off with just myself and one other union member, and then from there I was taking on more and more union duties to the point where I became part of Glasgow Local Association's Committee of Management, and then from there I became an EIS equality rep and started going to the EIS AGM. I've been going there each year since 2013, just taking on more and more responsibility within the union. Since being at university, I studied homophobia in the primary school, and it was something I was always interested in and realised that it was a problem in primary schools.
So in my experience, the homophobic language has been used a lot by children as an insult, and I find that absolutely abhorrent, and I have to challenge that.
As a student teacher, I experienced homophobia really for the first time in my life from a teacher that I worked with, and that was very surprising and something I wasn't expecting. That was when I realised that homophobia was real and it did happen in primary schools, even though I was finding it from my research. Since taking on this role within the union, I've realised that it is still very prevalent in schools, and it's something that needs to be tackled.
I feel that some teachers have the skills to deal with homophobia, but I think a lot of teachers don't have the confidence to deal with homophobia, and then they don't quite know what to do and where to go with this, so it becomes non-addressed. So I think being able to have those skills, have the knowledge, to be empowered, that will go a long, long way to just diminishing that, not just in schools but across society as well.
The union have taken me through a lot of training along with Stonewall and LGBT youth, and they've asked me to go and represent schools at Stonewall and LGBT youth events.
I was invited to attend the Challenging Homophobia course. It was a Saturday afternoon. I knew that Scott was going to be speaking at it, and I was interested in what he had to say. It was a great opportunity from different speakers, different workshops, people to be able to explain what they've been doing in their own schools, and it really enhanced my knowledge, and it gave me the confidence to go back into my own school and to be able to deal with that as well.
The feedback we get from the training course is always excellent. Teachers are always telling us how much more confident they are about dealing with homophobic issues within the school, be it homophobia within the staff room or homophobia in the playground. They're much more confident in dealing with that in general. There are also teachers who have come out in school as part of coming to the courses. One teacher, for instance, came out to his primary seven class the following week, and he said it's changed his completely changed his working life. And there's also teachers who have left the courses and developed LGBT committees within their secondary school, something which is more appropriate to a secondary school. And since then, they feel that their pupils are a lot more supported, and also that teachers who maybe didn't want to come out have joined that committee and are now out and work, and it's a much happier place for everyone, pupils and teachers.
As teachers, we all have responsibility for our own professional learning. And I think if this was available to everybody, it would be really well taken up, and it would enhance everybody's knowledge and confidence in going to deal with the homophobia that's surrounding in schools.
I've been very fortunate to attend the past three STUC LGBT conferences, where we've been backing other unions and they've been backing us, and we've worked collaboratively with them to ensure that our motions can be supported across all unions, and we're getting the best for all of our workers.
I think it's very important that teachers are members of a union, for that supportive background, for the information that it gives us. We have magazines that are sent out to us that gives us up-to-date information. We have reps in school that we can go to for advice. We have reps at higher level that we can go to for quite specific advice as well. And I think that we as a staff really need to be able to go and access that.